Hello everybody and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 with me, one of me, and our new king. Long live King Tyrone of England! Leofwild passed away. He fell asleep in the Lord. I don't know. Anyway, we need to pick a focus, and this is gonna sort of guide us. I think we need to focus on leadership and rulership right now, because we're gonna be doing a bunch of stuff. I don't know if we want to kill... What? Why are we trying to kill Pope and Sands? Why is he my rival? Oh. Picklin's got a new king. And we have a marriage tie with him. How'd that happen? Leofgifu. Daughter of Bjortgith. Daughter of Pantaloon, daughter of Pants, daughter of Decimus. I love that stuff. I don't really know why. Let's just cut that out. I don't care about that. I don't think there's any intrigue we need to do right now. This is a problem, but this is something we can take care of. We're going to be very busy. Very busy indeed. So, first things first, we need a council. Our council is awesome. And I like what they're doing, too. We need to start gaining the favor of the people. Our first ambition here will become exalted among men, because it's the only one available. Thor, we could not educate you correctly when you were in your impressionable years. Dr. Evil Badass will teach you the ways of manship. Mansmanship. And... weak claims, petty kingdom of Mead. Ooh, I like that. Who has that claim? An earl? Oh, no, that's Damnunia. West Francia? No. This one is Duchess Helga of Lancaster. Now, that one's probably not going to happen. Okay, so let's take a look at our vassals. They don't like us, but they don't hate us. We have some opportunities here. Let's dump the prison. Elfida, how you doing? Boop. Welcome back to not prison. 27 years old. Been released. Our kinsman, Earl of Wiltshire. See, now these people, they don't like me right now, but they won't hate me for very long. Soon they will love me. Both of these two are ambitious. But, yeah, no, I'm going to go ahead and release. Because I am merciful. I've been saving these up as sort of an opportunity. I don't know if I need to release Bjortgifu. No. Is it gonna make people like me? No? Alright. What about you? Nope. You get to stay. Aw, little kidlet. Nope. He's a Cornwallian. I don't know which other ones of these we need to release. There we go. You can go... It doesn't really matter what they did. I'm not concerned about that. I'm mostly concerned about getting the people... I want to make sure that nobody in our prison holds county titles. Title. Mayor of Bristol. There we go. Alright, so everybody else is just a jerk. Hanging out in prison. Some of them we could... Morcar used to have a title. But I don't care about him anymore or his little shitty family. No offense. So that will already have increased people's opinions of us a good deal. The big problem right now is that we hold too many ducatudes. So and the people in here that want duchies will not like us until we give them. So let's take a look at this guy. Do you deserve this duchy? You are ambitious, but depressed. Your son is good. House Blood. I'll do it. It's a bad idea. He should like us. Really, that's it? Well, I guess we still have short reign... and way too many held duchies. He wants the Duchy of Weiss as well? Oh, he's got a county down there. That may have been a mistake. I didn't check that thoroughly enough. So we need to give the Duchy of Weiss to someone. Could be to Countess Elfrieda if her son is content. Yeah. We could give him... That would work. Cut out the middleman. This is just an Earl. An Oxford. She is the Countess of Oxford. That's a funny little... Is he the chaplain here? Another Earl in the actual city? Or no, he's not. He's just a dude. What about you? He's my kinsman, so he should get priority as a member of our dynasty, even though he likes us less for some reasons. I think we will make him... Yes. Congratulations. Now the people that hated me because I held the Duchy of Weiss will no longer hate me for holding the Duchy of Weiss and wanting it. They'll hate him! Like this guy. Hey! What do you know? So I still have two too many held duchies. That means we're going to get rid of Essex. No, I'm not going to get rid of Essex. Norfolk. So let's take a look at our brothers. Prince Dr. Evil Badass. How would you like to rule in Norfolk? And, well, we'll deal with the rest later. Duchy of Essex. No! That one. East Anglia. The weird named one. So we gave him all of that. Now he's fairly powerful now, but he's super fucking loyal. I don't know if I care too much about holding too many duchies more than that. He should become available to us in a minute here if I unpause it. Who is this? Oh yeah, Thor. Why didn't you get educated? Educate yourself, come on. Alright, now is he available again? There he is. Okay. Yeah. Alright, let's take a look at our vassals again. Hey, hey! Getting warmer. What's your deal? Too many held duchies, short reign, large feudal tax, medium crown authority. Well, that's fine. So, we've managed to hold on to all of Essex, with the exception of this little county of Northampton, which is held by Countess Cuthberg, who is related to us through Rainbow, funnily enough. Daughter of Rainbow. I didn't know that you, Ooh, you matrilineally married to someone from House Iceling? A bastard? No. Don't do that. Why would you do that? My niece will inherit right now, her sister, but if they have children, and they will, that's unfortunate. We can just do a plot to revoke that, I believe. Wiltshire we could do, and Cumberland. But no Northampton. Haha. See our wife dead. Which would be interesting, because that would set up some funny inheritances. And give us a chance to marry again. But I think we're going to be okay with that. Now, there was one on here I was interested in. Mead. Is there any way I could get her? Will her children inherit? Will not be inherited unless pressed in war. That sucks. And this place seems pretty entrenched, aside from, you know, being surrounded by war and apparently under siege at the moment. By this guy, no less. Couldn't have given us a... Wait, what? Claim Irnignerg. That's his county. He's currently revolting against his liege? You really? You were his liege? Is that right? It must be someone else. No. ...49% in favor of the dude from Mead who... I don't know how that's happening because he doesn't have any troops over here. And he's being besieged over there. Maybe he's just started losing. Anyway, we don't need our retinue to go to Cornwall, because we're no longer at war in the War of the Five Kings down there. Kale the Dubaldzun is no longer guardian of whoever that is. Our daughter, apparently. Cuthberg is now known as the Unfaithful. Well, I guess we have to worry less about the... Whoa, hey. Are you in my prison? Ooh. Yeah, no, get out of there. We should get all the kids out. One of your vassals can be discouraged from joining factions. We have a potential for this one to like us, but what? Oh, what a horrible, horrible person. What a terrible person. I will ask her politely. And award her my swans. Have a swan, lady. Yes, she loves swans. Fucking idiot. Just fell for the old swan trick. Do not speak to me of obligations and duties. I may be your vassal, it doesn't make me your slave. Well, you haven't, so I guess I'll worry about that when you do. She's right, you know, old bean. Quite right. Anyway, money. So that's fun. Let's go ahead and get rid of all the children that we don't want necessarily. Can we ransom you? Really? Not interested? Let's just release. I don't wanna. No. Anybody we could ransom for good money? 10 gold to my kinsman. Alright. Eriker, no. He's a Viking guy. This guy's from County of Dyfed. Oh, my marshal. Sure. These people we don't hate anymore, so. County of Westmoreland. Hakon, not the good one. And Bishopric of St. Peter's. Wolfwaru, are you nuts? No. We're letting the people from our prison run free. Nuts as they may be, Tyrone will not be a tyrant. Only those who must stay in prison will stay in prison. So our threats right now consist of the Duchess of York, Elfeda, fuck that lady, and Werberg, who we released from prison, who's starting to like us a little bit. Right, Roadbird, I forgot about that guy. I had hoped he would be not a problem. Princess Pottery Barn, are you doing well? You're pregnant! Lovely. Have many children with King Yu, whatever, of somewhere, Tia. How's King Ninian? He's got himself a wife. She's craven as shit. And Welsh. Ooh. Could you not? War score 50% in favor of Flannan of Mead again. How are you losing this? You don't even have... Whatever. So this is a Yorkish problem, and they're going to kick those Vikings off of there. See, that's why we wanted to do it. Vikings no more. I am really tempted to do something about that Mead thing. What happened here? Oh. Yeah. Vikings. As you do. So how goes your war? 30% in favor of Tutbert. Now it's the War of the Four Kings. Technically, we still have some involvement as our wife. Who comes from a very noble family, and her children will not, is involved. But Aelstin. Aelstin has a bright future. Not a great guy. I'm hoping we can marry him to someone powerful, strong, genius. Something like that. Now, if we look at our pretenders, they're both of our daughters who don't like me, but mostly just because they're title claimants, pretender and claimant. That's not really a big deal. If they were of a different house, that would be a big deal. So we can change our crown authority, but we cannot change our centralization until we have legalism 5. It would be good if we had held on to all these titles. Holding 9 titles is quite a lot, actually. gives us a lot of money and power, and wow, that money. I might want to change the taxes. Just to make people like me even more. No. We're getting quite a bit of money from our own... High Crown Authority would be really, really bad for us. It'd mean that, you know, our titles could no longer pass outside the realm, but that's something that just comes down to management. Our country is small enough that we can manage that on our own. Make sure that that doesn't happen. Oh, we can hold a grand tournament, but not right now. I need 500 prestige? We could get married and get that by turning down a dowry. Let's buy some indulgence. Why would I want to do that? I thought you had to have borrowed money to do that. To the most illustrious King Tyrone, the good burghers of Maldon are barely able to pay their taxes. Our coffers are empty. That's expensive, but let's do that. I'll change taxes of my own accord. Thank you very much. No conditions. Just... I don't want to borrow money. I'm good. Not much we could do here. We just have to wait for some prestige before we can hold our tournament. So, Donuel Iceling seeks to see Countess Cuthberg the Unfaithful. I'm guessing that's... Well, it's the Duke of Lancaster, my spymaster. Oh, I see. Ah, that is... Okay, yeah. He's trying to kill Cuthby. Will he inherit? No. Can I join your plot? No. Alright, well, that's fine. Kill your wife. The Holy Father has granted us absolution. Ugh. Well, it's done. Let's see here. There's not much for us to build here, but we do have our new castle, the Barony of Bloodchester. I have been sort of neglecting this one, because it's expensive to do all of the things that we want to do. Go ahead and get our training grounds built there. That brings our money down a bit. All of our guardians keep kicking off. All of the people have been released from the prisons. Okay. I think everything's under control as far as our family is concerned. There's a couple of people. We could have him become a duke of somewhere. Like this. But I don't see any reason to do that yet. He's maimed as well. But Thor looks promising. Can arrange a betrothal for him. Anybody promising? Anybody good? Royalty? Princesses? Nope. What about... Oh, I can't arrange a marriage for Æthelberg. Or a betrothal. Or for Elfstan. Is he not... Oh, he's heir. I won't have any control over him whatsoever. Because when she dies, he will inherit that title, and he won't ever be in my court, per se. So I won't get to arrange a marriage with him. Right now, she is in charge of him. There's nothing I can really do about that. Tyrone, what the hell? Get your house together, Tyrone! And by that, I mean me. I think we're okay. I think we're okay. And I think now we can focus on grabbing up Wales and then Cornwall. And I think that's going to be our goal. So we're just going to go ahead and crank up the time here. And watch the world burn! I said the world, not me. We are ill. Man, picking rulership as a life focus is just a great way to get your guy killed. You always get ill and stressed and dead. Pope and Sans had a daughter, Princess Synagoguer. Pope and Sans and Synagoguer. Wait a minute. Oh no. Oh no! Still not inbred. Valentina. That's a pretty name. I'll allow it. During the visit to London, Baron Sinehome of Tauntaun. I know this one. So he made efforts to catch the thieves, Mill. Yeah. I will compensate. I gained the trait ambitious. Ooh, that's a good one. I am ambitious. Efforts to catch the thieves, I will personally compensate.
Essentially, both parties are not to blame for that. One did their due diligence, the other one, it was an accident. Church wants to organize a miracle play for a local saint in our domain. They seem to feel that it should fall on our shoulders to pay for it. It is, after all, for the glory of Bob. All hail Bob! Daughter was born to Gus Patrick Pantaloonson, an incessant Earthwolf's daughter. Oh, jeez. Oh! Oh! You will be amazed, blood. Saving you for later. Really? Just happened? Just happened to have an incestuous daughter of incessant. Wow, that's... That one's gonna look funny in the family tree. Oh boy, I gotta sneeze. Later, microphone. Oh, that was a toughie. Alright, I feel better. So yeah. Incest. Doing wonders. Prince Elfstan of England is of age. And he was very quickly married by our wife. To Emma Boson's daughter. Boson's doctor. Daughter of Duke Boson the Drunkard. Is she just some... Wow. One of her dukes. She seems fine. It's just... I would have probably found someone better. But, whatever. One thing I could do is give him a county. Never mind. Really? What if I send you a present? But I'm your father. I'll give you a thing. He loves me. Look, 100. What the fuck? That doesn't make sense. Like... That's a bit shitty. Bit shitty. Godor of Trogdor has been captured in battle. He's the Trogdor of Trogdor. No more burninating the thatched roofed cottages for you, sir. Get in my prison. Let's take a look at our people. Do they love me? They love me. For the most part. Mostly. Even the ones that hate me love me a little bit. They just want a lower crown authority. Countess Werberg wants her husband to be king. Do nothing for now. Whoa! Oh! Hello. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute! What are you doing there? Are you gonna get me a goddamn claim or not? Oh yeah, see, he's taking care of his business. Even taking his troops from Wiltshire. Which, I admit, I would rather be my troops in Wiltshire, but... Or, like, somebody corrects troops in Wiltshire, but, you know, you do what you can. We do what we must because we can. Happy New Year, 894. The rulership of a new king... I suppose, one of these videos, we gotta go through and look at the, glorious lineage of blood, but I was hoping we could get some stuff done in the old ye olde expansion of England. This is annoying that there keeps being armies ever so slightly too large for my retinue to handle on their own. How is that technology going? Oh. Super close. Marshall. Stop it. Military tech me. I don't even know if that works. But hey, we're not ill anymore.
So, we can pick a new life focus in 2 years, and we will. Don't know which one yet, but we will. The Pope loves me. And smallpox loves me too. Ooh, Ilfred Blood is now known as the Unchaste. Fleet full of loot has returned from raiding. Wait, what? Did I get this money? Because he's in my prison? I don't know. I guess he got the money, right? Yeah, he got the money. He gave it to him in my prison. No, Elstan. Yeah, he lost smallpox already. That's good. I don't know. I don't mind him necessarily getting small. I think we should maybe kill... Whoa. Is she the leader of the West Francian Revolt? She is, and somehow we're not involved in all of this. Apparently this marriage did not constitute an alliance. These are my lands that she is gambling away with, that drunkard. So she's attacking Huckbert. How did Huckbert fare in the war? It looks like the war is over. It looks like he lost. There's two revolts on his hands. Oddly enough, not in the county of Loon. Lithuania appears to have been the big winner in the War of the Five Kings, although it appears that it's actually still sort of going on. What happened to, Tutbert? Tutelberger. King Tutenberg. He must have died. Interesting. Nope, there he is. Holy fuck. Yeah, he's got problems. And he's got Gavelkind. So he's got problems, and then his problems have problems. I don't know, I guess we should maybe... We can't offer to join the war. I think I should request a divorce, but I don't know if that'd be good for me. And if we... kill her, would that be good for me? Can we? No, not even close. Yeah, I don't think it would be good for us to, yeah, I don't think it'd be good for us to divorce until she dies. And then we can divorce her all we want. She's not going to assent to those demands. An architect. New castle in Wessex. We've got enough castles. I know this man. I believe we can trust him. I guess we'll build another castle? What the heck? Castles are cool. I like castles. They'll help when the fucking Aztecs invade. I mostly just want that, though. Can I have that, please? Whoa! Duke Copsiege the Cruel has declared second Lancastrian claim on Purple de Burble. Alright. Good luck. Can I join his war? All help is appreciated. Sure, I'll help. What the hoot? Our guys like to fight. Can I fight? Yeah, I can fight. Let's go get some glory, boys. Noice. Let's go squish some guys. We request you honor your obligation to answer this call to arms against Matilda of West... Is that my wife? It is. Who's Duke Boson? That's the point of this war here. I can't see it unless I join on the other side fighting against our wife. I can't help it. That's too awesome. Yeah. What's up? I'm at war with my wife. How fucking cool is that? All's fair in love and war, they say. I'm gonna need my boats. Boat me. Boat me! Is that enough boats? Get a little bit more boats. Slightly more boats. Okay. That's enough boats. Alright, so I think... Where'd all your armies go, Lancaster man? Popey loves me. Why are we at war with you? You helping with the whole rebellion thingy? Yeah, this is not really our problem anymore. Braggy of Vestfold has usurped the title of... Who is this? Orc? House Orc? House Koss? Does this have something to do with the guy in my prison? I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, army please. Army me. Army me. Military me. I need soldiers. I gotta go teach my wife how to Dougie. Aw. That's too bad. Amaze blood lives on, though. Hey, our training grounds have been completed. We could maybe increase our retinue. What is all of this? Yikes. Alright, we need more boats. We need 55 boats to get all these dudes over. Maybe we just need less dudes. Well, no, maybe we just need more boats. Norfolk, you gotta have boats, right? No? Middlesex, you got boats? Boat me. Alright, that'll do it, I think. So join me next time, where we go to war on our wife in the bedroom and on the battlefield with me, 1F me.